I mean, can you imagine a wheat field in New York City? My name is Joyce Pomeroy Schwartz, and I met Agnes in the 1970s. I was working at Pace Gallery, and I actually was director of sculpture commissions. But I consider Agnes one of my mentors. I had just started working in the field of public art, and she really bridged the gap between those artists who wanted to put their art in public works, conceptual artists of the 60s and early 70s, who felt they didn't want to be in museums. So she really taught me a lot as I was working in the field, what artists could do. I wasn't as interested in artists who did what I call the stone and steel school of sculpture, but rather people who had ideas that would transform a place. But what was so unique about the Wheatfield is here we are in the most urban city of the world. And she is planting a farm field of wheat and is growing it. I mean, it really made this one of the most special projects you could imagine. You know, I'm a New York City lady and I'm not a farm person. And it really felt like a farm. You were in the wheat field and I would walk in the wheat field and you would feel it. And I would come from time to time just to see the wheat grow and see it change. I remember the smells of it more than anything else, that, you know, it smelled so fresh. The city didn't smell so good. It smelled oily and whatever. But there was something like, it was like smelling the outdoors in New York. And it just was a very special, incredible thing. And beautiful, because it was so simple. She brought art that you couldn't forget. It's part of New York's history.